Hello children, today we are going to discuss the properties of determinant. This is the first property. In the other classes, we have already discussed about the first four property. According to this property, if sum or all elements of a row or column of a determinant are expressed as a sum of two or more terms, then the determinant can be expressed as a sum of two or more determinants. Children, we can express any determinant as a sum of two different determinants. Here, a determinant a1 plus lambda 1, a2 plus lambda 2, a3 plus lambda 3. And the remaining elements of this determinant are b1, b2, b3, c1, c2, c3. We can express the given determinant as a sum of two different determinants. The elements of the first determinant are a1, a2, a3, b1, b2, b3, c1, c2, c3. And the elements of the second determinant are lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, b1, b2, b3, c1, c2, c3. We will express this determinant as a sum of two different determinants. Now we are going to illustrate this property with help of example. Let a determinant 5, 4, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 7. Children, we can write this determinant as a sum of two different determinants. Here we are going to write the element of first row as a sum of two numbers. We can write 5 as a sum of 2 plus 3, 4 can be write 1 plus 3, and 6 can be write as a 2 plus 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 7. Here, now we are going to write this determinant as a sum of two different determinants. So the element of the first determinant will be 2, 1, 2. 2, 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 7. Plus, and the another element of this second determinant will be 3, 3, 4. 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 7. The value of the given determinant is just equal to the sum of these two determinants. It means delta is equal to delta 1 plus delta 2. Here delta 1 and delta 2 are the two different determinants. Now, children, this is the last property of the determinant, property number 6. If each element of any row or column of a determinant, the equimultiple of a corresponding elements of other row or column are added, then the value of the determinant remains the same. That is, the value of the determinant remains same if we apply the operations. If any row or any column add with the another row by an equimultiple, here this determinant is now going to change by this rule. Here the rule is R1 tends to R1 plus K times R3. Here the first row is A1, A2, A3. Now after applying this rule, we will find the element of the first row are A1 plus K times C1, ए टू प्लस के टाइम्स सी टू, ए थ्री प्लस के टाइम्स सी थ्री. हियर द वैल्यू ऑफ द गिवन डिटर्मिनेंट एंड दिस डिटर्मिनेंट विल बी सेम. दिस इज द प्रॉपर्टी नंबर सिक्स. चिल्ड्रेन नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू इलस्ट्रेट दिस प्रॉपर्टी विथ हेल्प ऑफ एग्जाम्पल. Let us consider a determinant delta is equal to 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 3 and 1, 2, 4. Here we are going to change the first row by using this rule. Okay. But before going to change the first row by this rule, we will find the value of this determinant. After expanding after expanding this determinant along the first row, we will find the value of the delta is equal to minus 9. But after using this rule, r1 tends to r1 plus 2 times r3. हम लोग इसको 2 times, 3 times, 4 times multiply कर सकते हैं. ऐसा कोई hard and fast rule नहीं है कि इसको हमें 2 से ही multiply करना है, 3 से, 4 से. But here we are going to illustrate the property number 6. So we can multiply by any number. So the first row is now going to change by this rule. The element of the first row are 1, 2, 1. Now the first row is added with 2 times the element of R3. 2 times the first element of the third row is 1. This is the first element of first row and this is the first element of the third row. The first row plus 2 times the element of the third row. Now the next element, second element of the first row plus 2 times the second element of the third row. Now the next element, third element of the first row, 1 is the third element of the first row, plus 2 times third element of the third row. This is the third element of the third row, and the remaining two elements will be same. After simplification of the first row, the element of this row will be 3, 6, 9 and the remaining element of the last two row are 2, 1, 3, 1, 2, 4. After expanding this determinant along the first row, the value of this determinant is also minus 9. Children, here you are observing that the value of the given determinant is minus 9 and the value of this determinant after using this rule are same. Here the value of delta and delta 1 are same. This was the last property of this determinant. Thank you, friends.